Welcome back to the 7th episode of me trying to figure out how to build an entire guitar from scratch with very limited space, tools and materials. Now I know this episode is a tiny bit longer than usual, but I promise you it's all worth it. Now in this episode we are doing a little bit of cosmetic work on the body and also tackling the most important component of an electric guitar, which is the pickup. So stay tuned until the end of the video if you want to see how that turned out. Okay, so before going into how I'm dealing with the pickup, I still want to do some cosmetic work on the guitar. Now I've inlaid the fret markers and they look very nice. These are M4 brass washers and I kind of do like this whole brass theme on the guitar, so I'm gonna carry on with that. I want to inlay on the front and on the back where the oak meets the beech. I want to inlay these brass strips right where they meet. So I'm going to have to carve some channels. I'm gonna do that with a Dremel and this has a potential of basically ruining the guitar, but I'm gonna go with it. I'm gonna try and make that work. I'm gonna try and clamp this to the desk and see how everything goes. Now I've already done a test and I forgot to hit record on the camera, but it came out quite well. The brass rod looks quite nice in here and I think it will look very beautiful when it's finished. I'm now going to go ahead and clamp it up again and carve the second one on the back and then go to the front and do the same thing. So I'm now going to do a scratch pass just to check if everything is aligned and it looks nice, and then I'm gonna go on to full depth. Okay, so the scratch pass looks good. I'm gonna go to full depth. Hopefully everything will come out fine. Alright, so this does fit very nicely in here. A bit of super glue, some sawdust, and it's gonna be all nice. So now for the front, because I already have the fretboard in place, I cannot use the old Dremel router attachment because it wouldn't fit over the fretboard and it would be quite a mess. So I had to 3D print a jig, a Dremel attachment that will run on some rails basically. So these are some of the aluminium U-channels that are left over from the truss rod. So it came in handy. Basically what this jig does, it allows me to make a straight line while rolling onto the rails. Quick scratch pass and let's see how it goes. Looks good. I'm gonna go a little deeper until I get to the right thickness. Okay, so I just finished routing everything. It looks fine. I don't think there's been any problems with it. I'm gonna unclamp it and sort out the sawdust, which I don't want to get everywhere on my computer and in my room, and I'll show you how it all looks like. Okay, so this doesn't look bad at all. The brass rods fit here nicely. There is a little gap which I'm going to fill with sawdust and super glue, but I am quite pleased with this. Right, now the body looks a little weird, but you will see in the next episode why is that. It's gonna be quite a big surprise, but until then, I think the brass inlays are looking very nice here, so yeah. And we are getting now into the most exciting part of this build, which is the pickup. Now I say exciting because this is where I feel the most comfortable. I have a degree in music technology and audio systems, and theoretically this is what I should know the best. So building a pickup is not that difficult in theory. It should be a very thin wire wrapped around some magnets, and disturbances in the magnetic field should be picked up by the coil, which is in turn transmitted to an amplifier. Now, in practice, this is a bit more complicated because you need to find that thin wire. And given the challenge, which was to build the whole guitar, including the pickups, with basic materials, with materials found from around the house or in your normal local shops, this was a bit more difficult than I expected. Now, the most difficult part of this whole process was to actually find that thin wire. In normal pickups, you usually have 42 gauge or 43 gauge. That's some very thin wire. I searched around in some motors, I searched around in some transformers, and I couldn't find such a thin wire. Now, I did find the wire in one place, and I will tell you in just a second. I found the wire and I thought, okay, I'm going to 3D print some pickup cores, coil the wire around it, and it will all be fine, right? It wasn't that easy because the wire that I found was so thin that it would always break. It was as thin or even thinner than the human hair. So whenever I tried to coil it onto the core, it would always break. I tried many different methods. I made a jig, I tried with a power drill, I tried everything and it kept breaking. So this is where I got with that. I could never get it coiled onto the core. Now at that point, because I could see that I had no chance of winding that wire onto the core, I thought, okay, I'm going to break the challenge and I'm going to order some 42 gauge magnet wire, which is the normal wire that you use in winding pickups. Now I got this and I started winding some pickups, and you can see that they look like pickups and they are basically pickups. This is all good. I can make two of this and I can make a humbucker. Now this is all good and fine, and I can make some pickups out of these wires without any problem. They would sound like your normal pickups would. However, in the back of my mind, I always had this thought that I am breaking my own challenge, and I didn't want that to happen. I really, really wanted to make a pickup out of stuff that I can find around me, and also a pickup that would sound good. So in the meantime, I got this idea, and I will show you now where I got the wire from and how I'm going to go about making a pickup from a microwave. Okay, so I will now show you what I mean by that and how I'm going to go about this pickup. If you find a broken microwave, you will most likely find this inside. This is the motor that turns the platter. And if you take it apart, very easy to take apart, just a couple of clips. Throw this away. You find some gears, don't need any of this. Just pop them out. Take this plate out. You end up with this. You have a magnet on the inside, you take this out, we don't need this for now, and you end up with this, which is a coil of extremely thin wire. Now, what I was trying to do was put this on a jig, and I was trying to unwind the windings from here onto my normal spools. Now, what happened was that obviously I could not wind it because the wire was so thin. And after a while, I realized that I actually fell into the trap that I was talking about in my second episode, where traditional guitars can be built with a certain set of tools, a certain set of parts. But because I don't have that and I wanted a challenge, I have to improvise, I have to look for something else. But then I thought, wait a second, this is already coiled, this is already in a core, and it already has the terminations. Why would I try to coil it onto another core if I already have this in place? So my idea right now is to use it just like this. Put a magnet inside, some sort of a metal pole is gonna have just one pole with a longer bar on top, and that would be my pickup. So let's go and see if that can be achieved, shall we? So it is now the right time to assess what we need for this pickup. I'm going to try to use this coil as it is. I'm going to need a magnet, which will go inside. I'm going to use this tiny magnet that I found in a stationery shop. It comes like this. I'm going to use a nut that will go inside, and this will act like a pole. And then this is going to be magnetized by this magnet. And then on top of that, I'm going to use just a metal rod, which will go right under the strings. And this is what's going to interact with the strings and with the whole assembly. So I'm supposing I'm going to need a lot of super glue and some 3D prints, maybe. Let's see. So I'm now back and I've designed and printed a pickup cover in this very beautiful shiny silk PLA. Now all that's left to do is basically fit everything together, see how it all looks and see how it all sounds, and we'll take it from there. Okay, so I just want to show you how this all fits. So the rod is just press fitted in the pickup cover. I'm going to use some super glue and fix it in place for now. And then we need to make the coil fit. So we have to cut it a little bit, and then the magnet and the nut. And now we have the rod glued in place, and I actually don't think it looks bad at all. I'm quite pleased with this look, but let's carry on. We need to now cut this housing down so it fits in this enclosure. So we have it cut down to size, it now fits the enclosure, but let's now check if it survived the whole process. And success! It is still working, everything is fine. Okay, next step is to fix the magnet on the nut itself with some super glue and then fix it inside the case. I'm now going to solder wire to the terminals and plug it in and see if it makes any sound. Now we have to find a way to temporarily fix it before super gluing it in, just so we can test if it makes any sound. Everything looks secure. So what I'm going to do now is plug this in my audio interface and record a little bit and see if everything works. Here we go. Let's see if it does anything. And I think we have a pickup. I'm quite happy with this as it is now, but we're gonna do a little bit more. You know what? Let's analyze this pickup. Let's do a frequency analysis, because that's gonna be very interesting for the future improvements that I'm gonna make on this. How I'm going to do that? What's the principle behind it? We have to excite it with a sine sweep, a sine wave that goes from 20 hertz preferably 20, but I think it's going to be from 40. It's basically a sound sweep that goes from low frequency to high frequency, usually in the human audible spectrum. How we're going to excite the pickup is by using an exciter coil. Now, how you make this, if you want to make one, is take that old speaker that you said they're gonna use for something at some point, but never use it because it sounds too bad. Take it, rip it out, and take the coil from inside. This is going to be enough for making an exciter coil. You hook this up to an audio jack and to your phone, which runs a frequency generator app. I already have this set to go from 40 Hz to 20 kHz in a sine sweep. Now, I'm using this sending block just as a guide to always have the same distance to the pickup. So what's going to happen now? I'm going to Audacity and I'm going to record the sine sweep that comes from the exciter coil. So keep in mind, everything that you will hear is coming from the pickup. So let's start recording in Audacity as well. Now, you can see here that the second channel is my pickup. So I'm going to start the sine sweep. And that was it. What I can do at this moment is split this track up and run spectrum analysis. And sure enough, this is how our pickup looks like. And we can see that we have a peak over here at around 8K, which is quite a harsh tone. I'm not necessarily liking this, so I might do something to deal with this peak, which would make the pickup sound very bright and kind of nasty. So I know what I'm going to do now. I can definitely hear the 50 Hz hum, which is not really desirable. And I can see I have these high frequencies which are quite harsh and bright. What I'm going to do is get a second motor and take the coil out of this as well and add it to the first one as a humbucker pickup. It's not going to be a humbucker in the traditional way, but it's going to be a stacked humbucker where only the first pickup picks up the sound, but the second coil acts only as a dummy coil. So the second coil would pick up the hum and would cancel with the first one. Hopefully that would get rid of that peak, and if it doesn't, I'm going to do something else. But let's open this up and then take it from there. Okay, so we have the second coil shaped and ready to be installed. I will secure this in place, just glue this in place. There's no reason to delay it right now. And then solder the wires to the second coil and glue that in place as well. Okay, so we have that glued in. So there we have it. We have a pickup. We have a humbucker pickup. Hopefully, we still don't know that yet, but let's keep our hopes high for now. However, it's not going to sound like a humbucker because it doesn't have both coils side by side. So it's probably going to sound like a single coil without the hum and with a little bit of a different spectrum characteristic. So after a little bit of testing and playing around with all the different possibilities that I can have with this pickup and with these coils inside the pickup, I think I came up now with what seems to be the best configuration. Now, I found that the best configuration in which I can run the most silent one is in parallel. And this actually is convenient for another aspect. Each coil has a DC resistance of around 12.8K, kilo-ohms. Now, that is a little bit high for a guitar, but if I run them in parallel, then the resistance virtually decreases by half. So I would get a DC resistance of around 6k, which is quite normal for a guitar pickup. So what I think I'm going to do now with this pickup is, in the guitar, add a toggle switch which switches between the single coil and the humbucker in parallel. That gives me a little bit more versatility on top of everything that I have, because this is quite a limited pickup. I don't get a lot of tone with it. I still don't know how it sounds like, so I want that option to switch between different configurations. Now, before I leave, I will show you that the pickup actually works with a guitar string. So I have this tuner that I showed you last week, and I will just put it over the string, and you will hear that it does make a sound. Now, I hope you can hear that. Let me crank it up a little bit. Now you can see that even when I crank the gain way up, there is virtually no noise anymore with this pickup. But there we go. We have a working pickup. And with that, it is now time to wrap up this video. There is a whole lot of footage of an entire frequency analysis of the pickup, which I didn't include in this video because it would have gotten way too long. But if you want to see that in a separate video, please let me know. If you want to follow along to this build, please subscribe, like the video if you liked it. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you next week.